All new tonight at 6 o'clock. Did you know we have a world-class sleep and performance lab right here in Spokane? It's run by Washington State University. A lot of their research is on how sleep deprivation impacts your health. Our Hawk camera working for you tonight. And Hawk, the center just got a big new grant from the Department of Defense.
$2.8 million to be exact, Nadine. It's going to be used to pay for a 3-year study looking into how sleep deprivation impacts decision making. The study will require 90 human subjects. One of them could be you. Fun fact, it'll also use more than 250 rats.
It's not what you'd expect when you hear sleep study.
People are usually pleasantly surprised when they come in.
For some, it might be a trip down memory lane, like sharing an apartment or dorm.
Standard study for us is 4 days, 3 nights. You're here 24/7.
4 bedrooms, a bathroom, a kitchen. It's normal. The only difference, lighting is kept constant. There are no windows, temperature stays the same, and when you sleep, you'll be wired up. And there are always people watching.
We always have eyes on them.
It's all in the name of science. And there's about to be groundbreaking research going on here, looking into how sleep deprivation affects decision making.
People are sleep deprived. What we find is that they have really poor cognitive flexibility.
Or the ability to adapt or respond to a change. So why is that important?
That can lead to some really terrible accidents for people who are, you know, working around the clock, for shift work industries, for emergency medicine, for that's why the military cares.
The study, big picture, is simple. Sleep, then be sleep deprived, typically for 38 hours, and take tests the whole time to document how your brain is functioning. And while that work is done with humans, at the same time, rats will be used in a different lab at a more specific level, targeting brain circuits that might hold the clue to overcoming sleep deprivation using optogenetics.
With optogenetics, what we can do is we can take like an algal protein and we can transfect that on a neuron. And when the neuron is stimulated by blue light, it actually fires.
That then indicates which part of the brain to target.
Once you have a targeted area, you can then target, you know, specific gene therapies or drug therapies.
It's a big study, but one with a lot of potential applications.
And Dr. Davis says of the top 7 killers in the U.S., 4 of them, cancer, diabetes, car crashes, and heart disease, all have sleep loss as risk factors. He says sleep is still really understudied. So if you are interested in learning more or want to participate in one of the lab's studies, just go to our website, kxly.com. We have all the information you need right there. I'm Hawk Hammer, KXLY 4 News.
Very interesting. Thank you for that, Hawk.